Hi there,
and welcome to this demo video. The Bank Reconciliation Suite app from Fast4 will save you hours of processing bank transactions in NetSuite every day. Instead of manually entering and matching all of your bank transactions, our Suite app automatically reconciles everything in NetSuite, from invoices and credits to payments and expense reports, based on either an upload of your bank statement or a transaction fee directly from your bank, depending on your preference. First released back in 2013, our app is now used by over 500 NetSuite customers around the world to reduce the time, errors, and frustration caused by manual processing. What's more, due to the speed and ease of completing the bank reconciliation using our app, most of our customers reconcile within minutes every day to ensure their business-critical reporting is live and accurate. Now let's look at some of the main features of our app. Automate transaction entry. Our application imports your bank statements file and performs an auto-matching procedure within NetSuite. For example, money received can generate payment transactions against customer invoices, whilst payments made are linked to bills, journals, and other expenses based on auto-matching rules. Ad hoc transactions, such as card payments or bank interest gains, can also be easily created on the fly. Virtually all scenarios and transactions are supported with our app. Process complex scenarios easily. Foreign currency payments, consolidated payments, and payment differences can all now be processed with the click of a button, greatly enhancing standard NetSuite functionality. Single source of truth. The Fast4 Bank Reconciliation app will be your single source of truth, combining transaction creation and reconciliation of the bank balance in one single action. This leads to better control of your bank balances, better reporting, and elimination of errors. Manage as many bank accounts as you need. You are not restricted to managing one bank account. We can configure the Bank Reconciliation Suite app to manage as many bank accounts as you have, including different currencies or different formats. Manage credit cards and other payment providers too. Our app is also not restricted to just managing bank statements. Many of our customers take advantage of the configuration options to also automate the reconciliation of company credit card statement or payment files received from electronic payment providers, such as PayPal. Any area of your business where you need to manually reconcile payments made or received, our app should be able to help. My colleague Sarah will now give you a demo of the application.
Working with bank transactions can be a lot easier. Fast4 Bank Reconciliation automates handling bank transactions based on data provided by the bank in a bank statement. We use information on the statement like date, amount, payment description, and counterparty to find the right invoice or bill in NetSuite or to post the amount to a GL account automatically. With this solution, you can reconcile your bank statement, but you will find that Fast4 Bank Reconciliation will bring most value in automating bank transactions. You will never have to create a bank transaction manually anymore. When not auto-matched, it's just one or two clicks to handle the transaction. Let's take a look at how that works. When you use a direct connection with the bank, your bank statements will show up on a reminder in the dashboard, Bank Statements to Process. In this demo, I will manually upload a file that I downloaded from the bank's portal. I navigate to Transactions, Bank Reconciliation, Import Statement. On the left-hand section, I can upload a file for a single bank account. I am using the right-hand side because I am importing a file that contains data for multiple bank accounts. We support almost all file formats, like CSV, COMPT53, MT940, OFX, QIF, and various country-specific formats. I have configured an option for the bank that I am using. Later in the demo, I will show how this is configured. I select this import option and select the import file from my computer. The application splits the file into one statement per bank account. Here are the results. I can click a link to start processing one statement. They will also show on my dashboard on the Statements to Process reminder. I click on the link to process the first statement. The application now tries to match each line with invoices, bills, and custom matching rules. This happens real time and may take a few seconds depending on the size of the statement. This page, the bank statement, shows some information about the statement, such as the date range, the balances, and the number of lines it contains. Let's take a closer look at the balance fields. Statement start balance is the ending balance of the previously imported statement. Statement end balance is the calculated end balance based on the lines in the statement. In enter statement balance, you may enter the ending balance according to the bank. Some banks provide us with this information automatically. In this case, it's blank, so I have to enter it manually. This should be the same as the calculated value in bank end balance. The NetSuite balance field is still empty. After submitting the statement, the balance on the GL account in NetSuite will populate here. This is the same amount as on your balance sheet. When a statement is fully processed, this should be equal to enter statement balance and bank end balance. Let's take a look at the lines on this statement, starting with line 1. Some of the data from this line came from the imported statement, like the date, the counterparty, the description, the amount, and whether the amount is a debit or credit. The first line was auto-matched based on invoice number. I can see that in the name column, the customer in our NetSuite account is selected. In the transactions column, the matched invoice is shown. So the application could match the invoice based on the invoice number provided in the description. On the left, the Select checkbox is checked. Only lines with this checkbox checked will be processed on Save. This way, users can leave lines open and come back to it later. The fact that the application automatically checked the Select checkbox tells me that it was a perfect match. The amount paid is equal to the amount open on this invoice. If it would be a partial payment, it would still match the invoice but not check the Select checkbox. That would tell the user to inspect the line. Since this line was a perfect match, I can move on to the next line. Line 2 was not matched. If I know the customer, I can select it in the name column, and that automatically opens a pop-up that shows all open transactions for this customer. I can select the correct invoice and hit Submit. For the purpose of this demo, I am closing the pop-up again because I want to show a different way to find the right invoice. I can also open the pop-up without selecting a customer in the name column. This will give us suggested transactions. Based on a number of criteria, the app suggests transactions to the user. If no suggested transactions, use the search fields to find the right transaction. I select the invoice and submit. Lines 3 and 4 are both auto-matched. Line 3 is matched against 2 invoices, and line 4 against 3. I will show how that looks like for line 3. Since this is auto-matched, I can just move on to the next line. Let's take a look at line 5. In the name field, the customer related to this transaction was auto-matched. This is because we support matching on counterparty name. On the right, the field Matching Reason shows how this line was matched. That tells me this line was matched based on counterparty. The application has connected the name of the counterparty as it appears on the bank statement, Vodafone Netherlands, with the name of the customer in our NetSuite account, Vodafone. This functionality includes auto-learning. It remembers that Vodafone Netherlands refers to this customer. I now only have to open the pop-up with all open transactions for this customer. I choose the right invoice and submit. I can now move on to the next line. Line 6 is matched against a vendor bill. Matching on vendor transactions works exactly the same as matching on customer transactions. Line 7 is not matched. I want to post this to a GL account. In the Select Account field, I select Miscellaneous Expense and proceed to the next line. On line 8, the account is pre-selected. This is because of a custom matching rule. I will open the matching rule used on this line to show how that works. We created this matching rule for charges from Uber. It says that when the counterparty contains the word Uber, the account travel expenses should be selected, the name Uber Technologies, and the department sales. You may use these matching rules for all sorts of transactions that should be posted to a GL account, such as interest, bank service charges, or salary payments that should go to a salary control account. Line 9 was also matched by a custom matching rule. Line 10 is a prepayment to a vendor. I select the vendor. The pop-up opens automatically, but I don't want to match it against a transaction. I will just submit the pop-up. Posting an amount against a vendor will create a posting against the vendor that can later be applied to a bill. I have now processed all the lines on this statement. I hit Save. This will create payment transactions, impacting the GL for all the lines in this statement. It will take a few seconds. For short statements, this happens while the user waits. Long statements will be processed in the background. The user will receive an email when done. I get a green confirmation that all lines have been successfully processed. There are no remaining lines, and all bank balance fields are correct. I can now move on to the next statement. I now click on the link to process the second statement. Let's first look at line 2 of this statement. This is an example of a payment batch that I created through the NetSuite Electronic Bank Payments module. Some banks return the entire batch as one line on the statement, regardless of how many payments were included in the batch. Line 2 is such an example. On the statement, there is an option for matching against various other objects, such as matching on payment batches. I can simply match this line with the entire payment batch. This will attach all payments in the batch to the bank statement. Line 3 is an example of a payment difference. This customer paid €3,414 to our bank account. I select the customer and the pop-up opens. I select the correct invoice. Notice that the invoice is open for €3,424. I can leave it like this, applying a partial payment and leaving €10 open on the invoice. I can also select a payment difference reason here. I select bank fees, which will automatically post this €10 to an account I specified in the configuration. I am leaving the other lines open and move on to the third statement to show an example of foreign currency payments. Line 2 on this statement is an example of an invoice in foreign currency. The bank account currency is euro, and I sent an invoice in US dollar. The customer paid a US dollar amount to our euro bank account. I select the customer and the pop-up opens. This invoice is open for $15,877. NetSuite uses the exchange rate of 0.8831, but the bank obviously uses a different exchange rate and deposited €14,208 to our bank account. Upon selecting this line, the application automatically recalculates the exchange rate. Without using this application, the user would have had to manually calculate the exchange rate used by the bank, enter it into NetSuite, and check if the GL impact of the customer payment for any rounding difference. Let's take a quick look at the configuration. For every bank account, a bank account configuration record is created. This tells the application which type of file to expect, the date format, which matching options to apply, and some processing preferences. In this case, the configuration is for a CSV file import. Here is specified in which column the amount can be found, in which column the description, etc. Users can enable multiple matching options. The first option is to match open transactions on document number or parameters. Open transactions means open invoices and bills. These can be matched on invoice number, but users can also specify other fields that should be included in the matching algorithm. This can be custom fields as well. The second option is matching on amount within a date range. This will search for open invoices and bills for the exact amount as it appears on the statement. If there is a unique match, it will match the invoice. If there are multiple invoices open with that amount in the specified date range, it will not match. The third option uses the name of the counterparty as it appears on the bank statement to automatically recognize customers and vendors in NetSuite. If found, it will try to match open invoices and bills for that entity based on amount. The next three options are similar, but then on closed transactions. With closed transactions, we mean invoices and bills for which a payment has already been created in NetSuite. The last matching option enables matching on sales orders. This is used when customers are required to prepay based on a sales order. The app will create a customer deposit against the sales order, so when the invoice is created, the prepayment is applied automatically. The order of these matching rules can be changed if required. Under Processing Preferences, users can alter the way the application creates transactions. For example, some users might prefer to create unapplied customer payments instead of customer deposits. Finally, there are numerous features included in the application that are not shown in this demo video. I would like to take some time to highlight some of them. Rematching of existing statements, on demand or on a schedule in the background. This is helpful when the bank statement data arrives in NetSuite before all transactions are created. Payment gateway reconciliation. We have built in a very efficient process to reconcile payment gateways, such as PayPal, Stripe, or credit card payments. Direct debit reversals. When your company uses direct debits to collect payments from customers, they are reversed sometimes. This application auto-matches direct debit reversals and posts them correctly in the GL as a new transaction type called direct debit reversal. This process reopens the original invoice and registers the reason for reversal. That information can then be used in a dunning workflow. For example, reversals because of insufficient balance may be automatically debited again, but when it's denied because of authorization, an action for a user is created. Multi-line journals are helpful when one amount on the bank statement needs to be allocated to multiple GL accounts. Auto-processing is useful for customers with large volumes. Statements are automatically created, matched, and matched lines are posted. Users only need to manage the unmatched lines.
Finally, let's have a look at the pricing structure. The Bank Reconciliation Suite app is purchased as an annual subscription, so similar to NetSuite itself, with a one-time fee for implementation. Our pricing is calculated by the number of bank accounts you wish to manage, based on a multiple of 10. We also have an unlimited option available upon request. Implementation and training are carried out remotely at a time which is convenient for your team. This makes sure the app is installed correctly and that your team are confident using it from day one. Thank you very much for watching this video and thank you for your interest in our product. If you have any further questions, feel free to reach out to us. So get in touch and thank you for watching.